This video is all about trying to visualize floating point numbers. We checked out the floating point format in the previous video, and it was really just the technical specification of the format that we discussed. Floating point format is an objectively difficult system to understand and visualize, primarily because this is how we choose to represent floating point format, using the sign, mantissa, and exponent notation. And we derive the resultant floating point number using this formula. Sure, this looks complicated and it's not very intuitive, but the difficult part to visualize is what this formula isn't telling you. What this formula isn't defining is the precision of the floating point numbers and the least count between them. Let's do a quick comparison between 32-bit fixed point format and the 32-bit floating point format. Let's look at range specifically. 32 bits can technically represent 2 to the power of 32 distinct possible states. An unsigned 32-bit fixed point number can store numbers between 0 to 2 to the power of 32 minus 1. This is intuitive and easy to grasp. The difference between each number is 1. What about 32-bit floating point format? We can store numbers from around 2 into 2 to the power of 127 to negative 2 into 2 to the power of 127. That's a monumental range, way bigger than what 32 bits can store. How is this possible? Obviously, this isn't some magical format. There's absolutely no way to have this massive range within this limited 32-bit space if we were to represent each one of these numbers distinctly. There has to be some sacrifices made so that we can represent the whole range with an acceptable loss in precision. Now that's the interesting question. Where is this loss of precision? Where does this kick in? What does it even look like? Alright, let's just step back a little. We keep talking about precision here. What exactly is precision? Accuracy is another term quite often used in tandem with precision. Are they the same? No, not really. Accuracy is how close the result is to the real value, the mathematical truth. Precision is how specific the result is. Still quite unintuitive, but let's take a concrete example. Let's say you want to measure the length of a car. The mathematical truth is that the length of the car is 255 centimeters, let's say. But you're given a ruler that only measures in kilometers. You could say that the car is 132.327521 kilometers in length. Now, this is wildly inaccurate, since it is nowhere close to the mathematical truth. But it is quite a precise measurement, since it is very specific and has a very fine least count. Now, I could make the measurements and conclude that the car is 0 kilometers in length. Now, this is an imprecise measurement, since it's not very specific, but it is a lot more accurate than the previous measurement. The precise and accurate answer to this question would be 0.00255 kilometers. Alright, now let's take a look at the number 2 in fixed point format. What's the next number that's representable in this format? It's 3, of course. The difference between each consecutive number throughout this entire range is always 1. What about floating point format? What's the next representable number after 2? It's this number. Now we'll get to where this number comes from, but you can see that the loss of precision is not really a problem here for floating point format. It's got a really fine least count, miles better than that of fixed point format. The next number after that is just an addition of this precision value, and the next one after that is the same. So far, the floating point format is outshining its rival. Let's look at a bigger number, this one. This is 2 to the power of 30, by the way, and this can be represented in the 32-bit fixed point format. What's the next representable value in fixed point? Well, you've heard it before. The difference between the consecutive numbers is always 1 in fixed points. The next number is this. What about in floating point, though? The next possible representable value in floating point format is this. It's 2 to the power of 30 plus 128. The least count is 128. Numbers in between are unrepresentable. That's a massive loss in precision, wouldn't you agree? Let's try and understand how precision varies in floating point format. The following section is inspired by a blog entry written by Fabian Sanglert called Floating Point Visually Explained. The link's in the description, and I think it's a pretty interesting read. Instead of looking at the floating point format in terms of exponent and mantissa, we can instead look at it more functionally as to what the exponent and mantissa actually represent. We can call them window and offset. The window represents a window of numbers or a range of numbers. This is always a consecutive power of two numbers, like 2 to 4, or 4 to 8, or 8 to 16, or 1024 to 2048, or 2 to the power of 30 to 2 to the power of 31. It represents a range of numbers, essentially. The offset pinpoints the exact position within the window of numbers. Since the mantissa, or the offset section, is 23 bits in length, the window can be split up into 2 to the power of 23 distinct numbers. This is a constant for 32-bit floating point format. It doesn't change. All we are saying is, we're splitting the window into 2 to the power of 23 intervals. The smaller the window, the smaller the intervals, and finer the precision. As the window size becomes larger, each one of these 2 to the power of 23 intervals get larger as well. The precision is more coarse and granular. Let's calculate the precision. All we do is divide the total numbers in the range by 2 to the power of 23. When the window is 2 to 4, the precision is this tiny number. When the window is 1024 to 2048, the precision is this. It's growing and getting worse now. When the window is 2 to the power of 30 and 2 to the power of 31, the precision is what we encountered earlier. It's 128. All the numbers within the window have the same precision. Once we've reached the maximum representable number in a window, we can float the number to the right and represent the number within the next window. The cost of doing that is the added loss of precision. Here's a fun fact. That all numbers within the window of 2 to the power of 23 to 2 to the power of 24 have the same precision as that of fixed point number. The precision is 1. Below this range, the floating point precision is better than that of fixed point. And above this range, the floating point precision is worse off. Finally, I'd like to talk about one last way of visualizing floating point numbers. It's through a ruler. Let's say we have a 1 meter ruler. The least count on this ruler is 1 millimeter, so it has 1,000 markings on it to evenly distribute 1 meter. Great. So if you want to measure two distances spaced apart, then you can. If you want to measure the distances of the object spaced close together, you can measure that too, with the same level of precision every time. If you want to measure two distances spaced more than 1 meter away, then you can't measure it. You need a bigger ruler. This is analogous to fixed point representation. The ruler is fixed, so is the precision. The representable range is limited to what the container, or the ruler in this case, offers. What about floating point? In this case, you can think about the ruler itself scaling to meet the needs. If the distances to measure are close together, the ruler could shrink down. You still have 1,000 demarcations on the ruler, but they're all close together now. And so the precision with which you can actually measure the distance is higher. If the distances were far apart, then the ruler could grow in size. Again, there would only be 1,000 intervals in the ruler, but the distance between the marks increased this time. You could measure the distance no matter how big it is, but you can only measure them with a low degree of precision. This seems like a great tool, the scalable ruler. And it is. It absolutely is. But there are limitations. For instance, you can't use the same ruler to compare two distances, a really small distance and a really large distance. The small distance would be too small to even be captured by the limited precision that the ruler is operating at when looking at larger distances. We'll explore these limitations with real-world examples soon enough. But before that, let's just summarize what we know. Fixed point numbers give us fixed, predictable precision. With floating point numbers, you can store either very large numbers imprecisely or very small numbers precisely. If you remember this fact, then a lot of things become really apparent very soon. See you in the next one.